past medical history. Do you remember what the history was on that guy?
No.
Did he have any allergies?
I don't know.
What are you doing? You haven't done any of this.
I'm all right.
Well, we gotta go. We gotta clear.
It's okay. Yeah.
Well, come on, buddy. We gotta get going.
Yeah.
What was you picked up his list of medications, right?
Yeah.
Jordy.
Huh.
Are you feeling okay? I thought you were just kidding around. But now you're acting like your sugar's low.
I'm okay.
What are you drinking? This is Diet Pop. Hey, listen. I think your sugar's low. You're acting like your sugar's low. Have you checked your blood sugar?
No.
Here, listen. I want you to take some sips of this. Take some sips. Come on.
All right.
Just start sipping that.
Yeah.
So if this doesn't get any better, we're gonna get you some help.
Yeah.
Did you have lunch?
No.
Here, drink some more then. Drink some more.
All right.
Now let's talk about emergencies that can occur due to blood sugar problems. So some of the first signs and symptoms of a person who might be experiencing a sugar issue is that they become confused. They might start messing with something. They're kind of doing random acts that are not coordinated, or they start saying things that really don't quite add up. And that will progressively get worse, both with high blood sugar and low blood sugar. But I think there's some distinctions we should make. When a person is suffering from high blood sugar, regardless of their diabetic condition, high blood sugar usually comes on slower over time. Now, the side effects are less drastic, but they really end up kind of being the same. Confused, headache, not feeling well, and eventually they will go unresponsive and end up dying if they're not treated appropriately. Low blood sugar, on the other hand, actually occurs much more quickly, and the onset could be from minutes to, 10, 15, 20 to maybe less than an hour, where this person really begins to lose their blood sugar and they really get confused and do things randomly much more quickly. Now, the treatments in our situation are going to be the same, but the condition is different for the long-term definitive treatment. So keep that in mind as we go through this. So what would you know about a high blood sugar event versus a low blood sugar event? The fact that they are basically having these symptoms gradually come on, their body is trying to burn off the blood sugar any way it can. That could be through urination, it could be through hyperventilation, and what happens when they hyperventilate is they're actually blowing off ketones. Ketoacidosis is the byproduct of unused sugar or improperly used sugar that's becoming a bit toxic in the body. And the body knows it's got to get rid of this. And again, if it can't urinate it out, it's going to even try to respirate it out. And so what we might smell in a high blood sugar situation is that fruity acetone type of smell, that almost like cheap wine kind of smell on the breath, but they haven't been drinking wine, and they haven't been eating fruit. And so that might be a giveaway that they may be fighting high blood sugar instead of low blood sugar. However, let's not get hung up on knowing whether it's high or low. If they begin acting confused, if they begin to kind of show some of those signs and symptoms that they are having a blood sugar issue, the way that we treat that is to rule it out with sugar. Now, it can be done through over-the-counter, where you just have soda randomly available, or it can be done through other particular products that are designed to be used for diabetic emergencies, specifically low blood sugar. Now, these can only be used if the person can actually swallow safely. If they're to a point in their sugar event where they can no longer control their swallowing reflex without choking, it's too late. We need to activate EMS, call 911, and get help on the way so that we can get them the sugar that they need through IV or through glucagon treatment through an intramuscular injection. But as long as this person was still able to kind of follow commands, they weren't getting overly aggressive or agitated or combative, we could possibly just encourage them to start drinking some soda or something with some glucose in it to rule out the sugar issue. If it's low blood sugar, this should help within about 10-15 minutes. If it does not help after 15 minutes it's an EMS call. We might have something else going on. But as long as they're trying, as long as it's improving and not digressing, we're heading in the right direction. But some of these other products I like a little better than relying on soda or a candy bar because they're designed to absorb quickly and they're designed to be more stable when they're in their packages. What do I mean by that? Well, if I was gonna rely on a gel or on a liquid, what happens if it's in my car and it gets freezing cold outside and the substance turns into ice? Well, that's not gonna work very well. So you got these glucose tabs that are really stable and it's gonna be very difficult for them to freeze to a point where the patient cannot chew them up and absorb that much needed glucose. One of the things to think about though is the soda diet or is it regular? You know, time and time again, I've kind of responded to places where they said, yeah, I was getting pop or soda and it wasn't helping. And I look at the bottle and it turns out to be a non-sugar product. And that would explain why it's not affecting the diabetic or the low blood sugar event. There's also the concern that we're dealing with fibrous, longer absorption rate foods, which are great for sugar problems that are slowly kind of creeping in and you know it. And so you eat a snack to try to stabilize the dip, but not for emergency rescue of low blood sugar event. This is something we need to have that's going to absorb quickly. Keep an eye on the actual dosage. Remember, most of these people that have sugar problems, they have talked to their physician, and the physician has told them what kind of grams they should be trying to absorb when they're running into a situation. These are 4 gram per tablet glucose tabs. So if he was supposed to get 20 grams of glucose, we would need to give them 5 tablets, not just one. So keep that in mind when you look at the different grams of sugar per serving or per dose when you have these available for you. This container is 70 grams of sugar just in this one bottle. Obviously, a third of the bottle is going to be plenty of sugar to try to bring that blood sugar up. But because it may be made out of high fructose corn syrup, the burn rate of those sugars is going to be much more rapid than a longer acting dextrose. They're all gonna burn out though. So after they've experienced that diabetic emergency, it's important that if it's the first time, you follow up with emergency medical services and get them the definitive care that they need. And if they're a known diabetic and they know how to keep it going or they can explain why they had the sugar event, then get them back on the plan so that they don't have it again. Maybe they took their insulin, but they didn't eat lunch or whatever the case may be. Or it may be time to check in with their physician, let them know what happened, as they might be fighting an infection or something may have changed with their diabetes. Either way, contacting emergency medical services is always a great backup plan and buys us time for their sake and getting them back on track so that they can get their diabetes under control.